On August 4, the first anniversary of the Beirut blast, residents of the city took out a march with a mock guillotine outside its port that was ripped apart by the explosion. Elsewhere in the city, protesters clashed with police with stones and fireworks. They wanted answers and the guilty to be punished. A year after the blast, one of the biggest non-nuclear explosions in history that killed more than 200 people and injured about 7,000 others, it is still not clear who was responsible for the incident. Authorities have said that the blast occurred after a fire at the warehouse that had stored ammonium nitrate, a highly explosive material. But it is not clear who stored ammonium nitrate in a warehouse in the middle of Beirut's densely populated city center, or for what. While these questions are yet to be answered, the blast has worsened the country's economic and political crisis, further deepening the public resentment. Amid mounting public anger after the blast, Prime Minister Hassan Diab announced his resignation in August last year. But a year later, Lebanon's political elites still haven't formed a government, and Mr. Diab is continuing in his caretaker capacity. Three leaders were appointed as Prime Minister-designate since the blast, and two of them stepped down. In September, Prime Minister-designate Mustafa Adib abandoned his weeks-long efforts to form a government as he failed to reach a consensus with the major political blocs. In October, former Prime Minister Saad Hariri was appointed by the President as the new Prime Minister-designate. 9 months later, Mr. Hariri stepped down without a cabinet. Mr. Hariri said he failed to reach an agreement on portfolio allocation with President Michel Aoun. Mr. Aoun later released a statement on Twitter saying Mr. Hariri was not ready to discuss amendments to his proposals. After Mr. Hariri's failure, billionaire businessman and former Prime Minister Najib Mikati was tasked with forming the next government.